Go back to your scriptures. Go back to your Vedas and realize that God is one.
Division in Islam is prohibited.
We understand the concept of God in Hinduism.
Quran is the most positive book.
Every day, more than 3,000 fetuses are being aborted in India after they identified that they're females. According to the statistics of 1996, US Department of Justice, 2,730 women are being raped every day. Every 32 seconds, one woman is being raped. I've been raped in US until the time I'm here.
Islam has the solutions to the problems of the West. Of the West.
We find that the international media, they are bombarding misinformation about Islam. Some of the international news channels, they are saying war for peace. The Islamic madrasas should be banned. Why? Because they produce human beings who cause terror.
Strategy used by the media to malign Islam is many a times they pick up the black sheep amongst the Muslim community and they portray as though they are exemplary Muslims. The other strategy used by the media to malign Islam is they quote many verses of the Quran out of context. The third strategy used by the media to malign Islam is they give a wrong meaning of the verses they quote, either of the Quran or the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The fourth strategy, they quote things which are alien to Islam. It doesn't exist in Islam, but they attribute it to Islam. And the fifth strategy used is, they quote things of Islam correct, but they give it a different angle. Jihad is an Arabic word coming from the word jahada, which means to strive, which means to struggle. Even if you know one verse of Islam, as long as you know it correctly, it's your duty to propagate it. Every Muslim should be a da'i. The problem is we aren't following the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the reason we are in this state. Allah says He will not help people who will not help themselves. Who is to blame? We are to blame. After 9/11, it has reached epidemic levels, maligning Islam. And I had gone to USA 2 years back, in October 2003. I had gone to Los Angeles and I was prepared, wearing a tie and a coat, beard, cap, kufi. I was prepared that I will be questioned. A da'i has to be prepared. So when I went to the immigration, beard, cap, go for inquiry. I was prepared. They asked me, why have you come here? I said, I'm getting an award. Award for what? I said, award for humanity. There's an organization in Los Angeles, in USA, giving me an award for humanity. What work have you done? I told him, I spread truth. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, seek ye the truth and the truth shall free you. I'm a person who spread truth. I wasn't lying. I'm a da'i. I'm spreading dinul haq, the religion of truth. And they asked me various questions to cut the incident short. When I went through the custom, they opened my bag and they found my video cassette, Jihad and Terrorism. They asked me, do you believe in jihad? I said, yes. Even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, believed in jihad. He said you have to strive. Even I believe in striving. I believe in what Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, that you have to strive. No, I mean, do you believe in fighting? I said, it is mentioned in the Bible. In the book of Exodus, chapter number 22, you have to fight. It's mentioned in the Bible, in the book of Exodus, chapter number 32, you have to fight. In the book of Numbers, chapter number 31, you have to fight. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says in the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 22, that take the sword and fight. But then, that custom officer being a Christian, no, but that's in self-defense. I said, that's what even I fight for, self-defense. They told me, sir, can I ask you one more question? I said, no problem. I just told my host that, I'm just doing dawah in the immigration, don't bother. I as a Dai should not get scared of truth. I started my talk by quoting that verse of the Quran from Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 81. وَقُلْ جَعَ الْحَقْ وَزَاكَ الْبَاطِلْ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوكَ. When truth is heard again, falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood, it's by its nature bound to perish. And alhamdulillah, after 9-11, everything has become strict. Visas have become strict. But alhamdulillah, I have traveled after 9-11 to USA, to Canada, to UK, to Australia, to Malaysia, to Singapore. And I've got 10 years visa of USA, 5 years visa of UK, Canada, 2 years visa. Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. Yet, I do not mince my words. I'm very clear. When I go for lectures, I say I'm come for lectures. When I go for spreading truth, I say I've come for spreading the truth. Depending upon the situation where you are, Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, Ta'alu ila kalmatin sawa'in bayna baynakum. Come to common terms as in us and you. Many of you may be aware of the situation in India. It's not easy to do da'wah, especially the city where I come from, Bombay. One of the most difficult places to do da'wah, according to me, it is Bombay. But Allah is the one to protect. There itself I speak. I quote the Vedas. I quote the Bhagavad Gita. I quote the Upanishads. But there, my strategy changes. There are many Indians who say, the Muslims are terrorists. This Quran, it propagates that you should fight. What kind of religious book is this? I tell them, have you read your Mahabharat? Mahabharat is one of the sacred scriptures of the Hindus. Your Mahabharat has got more verses of fighting than the Quran. It will put the Quran to shame as far as verses of fighting is concerned. So the Hindu tells me, no, but this is a fight between truth and falsehood, haq and batil. I said, the same fight is in the Quran also. Oh, then we have no problem with the Quran. And the most commonly read scripture among the Hindu scriptures is Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is nothing but an advice given by Shri Krishna, the God of the Hindus, to Arjun. It's mentioned Bhagavad Gita chapter number 1, verse number 43 to 46, that Arjun, in the battlefield, he puts his weapons on the ground and he says, I would prefer being killed unarmed than to fight my cousins. Mahabharata is a fight between the cousins, the Pandavas who are 5 and the Kauravas who are 100. And Bhagavad Gita is a part of Mahabharata, 25 chapters. He puts his weapon down, Arjun. Bhagavad Gita chapter number 1 verse 43 to 46. And he says, I would prefer being killed unarmed than fight my cousins. Immediately, few verses after, chapter number 2, verse number 2, Shri Krishna says, O Arjun, how could such impure thoughts come in your mind? How could you be so impotent? God Almighty, Shri Krishna, is calling Arjun impotent. You will not enter the heavenly planets. You are incurring a sin. And the full Bhagavad Gita is nothing but advice given by Almighty God to Arjun that he should fight his cousins. It's further mentioned in Bhagavad Gita chapter number 2, verse number 31 to 33, that, O Arjun, you are a Kshatriya. It is your duty to fight on religious grounds. If you do not fight, you will incur sin. If you fight, you will go to the heavenly planet. And blessed are those Kshatriya who get an opportunity to fight. Imagine if I tell the Hindu, your almighty God, Shri Krishna, is forcing Arjun to kill his cousins, it will be devilish. What he's doing, he's telling that if you have to fight for the truth, even if you have to fight against your cousins, you have to fight. That's what the Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 135. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believe, stand out for justice as witness to the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it be against yourself, against your parents, against your relatives, whether rich or poor, Allah protects both. Same thing. And very often, a common hadith is quoted to malign Islam. Hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 4, in the book of Jihad, chapter number 2. Hadith number 45. And the critics, they quote, your Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, that if a mujahid is killed in the battlefield, he will go to heaven. If he comes back alive, he gets the wealth of this world. And even the critics of India, like Arun Shuri, they quote this hadith against Islam. I tell them, haven't you read the Bhagavad Gita? Bhagavad Gita says in chapter number 2, verse number 37, Shri Krishna, the God of the Hindu, he is telling Arjun that, oh Arjun, go and fight. If you are killed, you will go to the heavenly planets. You will go to Swarg. You will go to heaven, to paradise. If you come back alive, you will get the booty of this war. Verbatim translation of Sahih Bukhari. Verbatim. I tell these Hindus that haven't you read your own scripture? You want to take out false in the Quran and the Hadith? Based on the guidance given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ta'ala ila kalmitin sawa im baina bainakum. Come to common terms as us and you. So we Muslims should know how to do dawah, how to convey the message, how to turn the tables over. As I told you earlier, I was in UK, and they say about Muslims, oh, suicide bombing, Muslims are killing innocent people. There's a book written by an associate professor in political science in the University of Chicago by the name of Robert Pape. He writes a book by the title Dying to Win. He's supposed to be one of the best experts in suicide bombing, in suicide terrorism. Number one in USA, Robert Pape. The book is Dying to Win. He writes in his book that suicide bombing was alien to Islam. If you read the history of Islam, the Quran and the Hadith, do you find any suicide bombing there? No. The first people who got involved in suicide bombing were the Tamil Tigers. Later on, it was the Marxist-Leninist. And Robert Pape writes that in Iraq, before the Americans came to Iraq, there was no suicide bombing. After the Americans came, then suicide bombing came. Not a Muslim, a non-Muslim, a Christian, an American who's supposed to be an expert on suicide bombing, Robert Pape. And you can give talks on the books written by Americans and non-Muslims.
Osama El Shami.
How can we get our children ready for the month of Ramadan?
Sharing the stories of what the Muslims have been through in the past, in particular the first generation.
Nazir Irfan Al Mujahid.
Make this Ramadan very special to them.
Your taqwa, your righteousness, your goodness.
I want you to tell me about your experiences from the very first Ramadan that you experienced as a new Muslim.
The first Ramadan I experienced was amazing.
Umar Debois.
When I embraced Islam, it was like I was prepared. You know, Allah prepared me for something that I had no idea. It was an amazing experience.
Beautiful. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to our program, The Straight Path.
Build your character on the path of the Quran and Sunnah in The Straight Path. Tomorrow at 3 p.m. and repeat telecast at 1 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV. Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Solution or problem?
Islam.
Heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half or Bitter Half every Sunday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
Pearls of Prophet Muhammad. Peace be upon him. Narrated Anas bin Malik. May Allah be pleased with him. The Prophet, may peace be upon him, said, make things easy for the people and do not make things difficult for them, and give them good tidings and do not repel them. Sahih al-Bukhari, Volume 1, Book of Knowledge, Hadith number 69.
we should know how to convey the message of Haqq. In UK, we know they have a problem of IRA. Fine? It is nothing but Catholic terrorism. But do they label it as Catholic terrorism? No. Why? If any Muslim is involved, Islamic terrorism. Non-Muslims are involved, they talk about the region, not about the religion. Why? This is how the media, it picks up information and they portray it in the wrong way. The media, for example, if it comes in the Indian media that a 50-year-old Arab comes to India and he marries a 16-year-old girl, headlines, 50-year-old Muslim Arab married a 16-year-old girl. But when a 50-year-old non-Muslim rapes a 6-year-old girl, it comes in news brief. I mean, that human being is taking permission of the parents, marrying with permission, giving her due rights. What is the problem? Here a non-Muslim 50-year-old rapes a 6-year-old girl, it comes in news briefs. We know of the Oklahoma bombing. Middle East conspiracy, continuously. When they came to know it was an American soldier, the news died out in a couple of days. And you can give multiple examples how the media is playing games. And today they say that Islam is the religion which was spread by the sword. A very good reply is given by Delesi O'Leary in his book, Islam at the Crossroad, on page number 8. It says that history makes it clear that the legend of fanatical Muslims sweeping across the world, forcing Islam at the point of the sword over conquered races, is the most fantastic myth that historians have ever repeated. Delesi O'Leary, the very famous historian, he says that history makes it clear that the legend of fanatical Muslims forcing Islam at the point of the sword over conquered races is the most fantastic myth that historians ever repeated. We Muslims, history tells us, ruled Spain for about 800 years. We didn't do our job. We didn't do dawah. Later on, the Crusaders came, we wiped out. There was not a single Muslim who could openly give the azan. We Muslims, we have ruled the Arab lands for the past 1400 years. For a few years, the British came. For the few years, the French came. But we Muslims have been the lord of the Arab land for the past 1400 years. Yet today, statistics tell us there are 14 million Arabs who are Coptic Christians. Coptic Christian means Christians since generations. If we wanted, we could have converted every Arab into Islam by the point of the sword. We didn't do it. These 14 million Coptic Christians in Arab land, they are bearing witness, they are giving shahada that Islam wasn't spread by the sword. We Muslims, we ruled India for about 1,000 years. Today, more than 80% of the Indians, they are non-Muslim. If we wanted, we could have converted every Indian at the point of the sword. We didn't do it. Islam does not give us permission. These 80% non-Muslim Indians, they are giving shahada, they are bearing witness that Islam wasn't spread by the sword. Which Muslim army went to the east coast of Africa? Which Muslim army went to Indonesia, which has the largest population of Muslims? Which Muslim army went to Malaysia, which has more than 50% Muslim? Which army? Which sword? It is the sword of the intellect. As Allah says in Surah An-Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125, Udu ila sabili rabbika bilhikma wal ma'udit al-hasna wajadil bilhiti ahsan. Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. There was an article, a survey done by Hira Rajesh Almanic yearbook in 1984. It was repeated in the Plain Truth magazine. A survey was done about the increase in the major world religions in a span of 50 years from 1934 to 1984. And number one, the maximum increase was in the religion of Islam, 235%. Christianity, only 47%. I'm asking the question, which war took place in the span of 50 years between 1934 and 1984, which converted millions of non-Muslims to Islam? Which war? Today, The fastest growing religion in the world is Islam. The fastest growing religion in America is Islam. The fastest growing religion in Europe is Islam. I'm asking, who is forcing these Americans, these Europeans, to accept Islam at the point of the sword? Before 9/11, the maximum allegation about the media was that Islam does not give rights to the woman. Do you know, out of those people accepting Islam, including in America and Europe, out of those non-Muslims accepting Islam, 2/3 are women. If Islam degrades the woman, then why do these American women, why are these European women accepting Islam? Why? The media is saying that Islam degrades the woman, then why are these American and European women accepting Islam? Because Islam has the solution to the problem of womankind, especially the womankind. They find security in Islam. We know Yvonne Ridley. She had gone to Afghanistan to spy on the Taliban. She was arrested for 7 days. She comes back. She's so much impressed. Time does not permit me to speak about details. Many of you may be aware. She reads the Quran and she accepts Islam. People ask her that, how did the Taliban treat you? They treated me like a guest. The amount of respect they gave her, the amount of modest behavior it was, it changed her heart. And mashallah, today she's wearing a hijab, she lives in London. A British reporter sent to write against the Muslims accepts Islam, alhamdulillah. And after 9/11, whenever I go to America and Europe, there are more non-Muslims coming to my talk than before. More Americans, more Europeans. I believe in the verse of the Quran, Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 54, which says, Makaru makarallahu wallahu khairul makrin. They planned and plotted, Allah too planned. Allah is the best of planner. After 9/11, in the span of 9 months, in USA alone, 34,000 Americans accepted Islam. According to Yvonne Ridley, in a span of 9 to 10 months after 9/11, 22,000 Europeans accepted Islam. The more they're attacking Islam, the more Islam is rising. Not because we are doing our job. Wallah, we aren't doing our job. You and I are not doing the job. Allah gives a promise in the Quran in no less than 3 different places. In Surah Saf, chapter number 61, verse number 9. In Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 33. And Surah Fatah, chapter number 48, verse number 28, Allah says, Huwa allazi arsala rasulahu bilhuda wa dinil haq liyuzhirahu ala dini kulli. That Allah has sent his messenger with guidance and the religion of truth, so that it will prevail over all the other religions, over all the other ways of life. Islam is destined to supersede all. This religion of peace, this religion of haq, will supersede all the other ways of life. And enough is Allah as a witness. However much the non-Muslim don't like it, however much the mushrik don't like it, Islam is destined to supersede all. Allah does not require you and me, the rubbish that we are. Allah doesn't require you and me. Allah is sufficient to make his deen prevail. He is giving us an opportunity to do a prophet's job and to earn a prophet's reward. He is giving us an opportunity to dawah. This religion is going to prevail. This deen ul haq, this deen of truth, this religion of peace is bound to prevail. And a very good statement was given by Adam Pearson. He says that people worry that one day nuclear weaponry will fall in the hands of the Arabs, they fail to realize that the Islamic bomb has already been dropped. It fell the day Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was born. Now let us analyze what does the media say. We'll discuss about each type of media in brief. First, regarding the print media. According to an article which came in the Time magazine, on 16th of April, 1979, written by a Christian, he writes that more than 60,000 books have been written against Islam in a span of 150 years. From 1800 to 1950, more than 60,000 books have been written against Islam. If you calculate, more than one book is written every day. More than one book is written every day against Islam and against a prophet. And after 9/11, this has reached epidemic levels. Every day, several books are written against Islam. And we Muslims, what are we doing? These Christian missionaries,
they are spreading. They are doing their job. They are printing literature and distributing. Here we have one sample. This is, I asked an Arab sheikh in my last trip, what is this? He read Allah Muhammad. But if you read very carefully, it is not Allah Muhammad, it is Allah Muhabbah, which means God is love. It is a quotation of the Bible from the first epistle of John, chapter number 4, verse number 16. God is love, and the verse continues, whoever dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God is in him. Verse of the Bible. If I give it to the Muslims, most of them will kiss it and keep it in the pocket. The moment they see Arabic, Allah's kalam, in the pocket. Arabic means if you find any Muslim, any Arabic literature on the floor in India, Pakistan, or any other non-Arab countries, when they find, they'll kiss it and put it in the pocket. As though it's Allah's kalam. It is a snake in the house. There are various posters. I didn't have time to get it. When you read it, oh, Rabbana. The moment you see Rabbana, the next verse is Atina, Fid Dunya, Hasnato. We are trained. It is not Rabbana, it is Abbana, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Verse of the Bible. They distributed among the Muslims. And we, colorful. This is a photocopy. Four color job, beautiful. You put it in your house. They are using deceit. They are using deceit to enter our homes. I have given the talk on deceit by the Christian evangelism. Time doesn't permit me to go into details. That's a lecture by itself. You can speak for hours together on each of these topics. And I remember, since I subscribed to many of these Christian organizations, I've got a beautiful calendar. So one alim in our organization, mashallah, knows Arabic. How do you like the calendar? Oh, beautiful calligraphy. Can I take it home? I said, take it. He keeps it for a week. Then I ask him, how do you like the calendar? Beautiful, Zakir bhai. I said, get it back. He said, why? I said, get it back. Then I said, read it carefully. Then he realizes those are verses of the Bible in Arabic. The Christians have come out with a Bible contextualization, a new Bible. If you read, it reads, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. They are taking verses from the Quran and converting it, changing a little bit, as though when Arab read will think it's a part of the Quran, actually it is Bible, known as contextualization. Kitab al-Muqaddas. As I told you, time doesn't permit me.
An evil is approaching, is approaching, is approaching, is approaching. A gap has appeared in the barrier of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, like this. This is part of a hadith that was spoken over 1400 years ago. And if it was near then, imagine, imagine how near it is now. My name is Muhammad Tim Humble, and in this series we explore the hadith of Sahih Muslim that speak of the trials and tribulations that are to come in the end of days.
Know and understand the signs of the final day to increase your taqwa and protect your iman in end of days. Today at 6 p.m. and repeat telecast at 5:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
Says indeed my prayer, my sacrifice, my life and my death are all for Allah, sustainer of the world.
A Dai Dynamic.
I challenge any human being to point out a single fundamental of Islam.
In youthful quest.
Which is against humanity as a whole.
Iconic, inspiring, encouraging.
Don't judge Islam based on the followers.
Farik Naik.
Judge Islam
based on the authentic sources.
That's the glorious Quran and the authentic Hadith.
Son of the world famous orator on Islam and comparative religion, Dr. Zakir Naik.
giving us an opportunity to do a profit job and to earn a profit reward.
A star above par in Teen's Star today at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV. The solution for humanity.
Just in brief, what we Muslims are doing. I come from India, which has a population of more than a billion people, out of which, safely you can say, 160 to 180 million are Muslims. We have many Muslim magazines for dawah purposes, etc. What is the quantity that they print in India? How much? 4,000, 5,000, 8,000. Number one English Dawah magazine, Islamic Voice, 15,000. I was in America a few years back. Before this trip, I was there. I did a survey. The maximum number of print, any English magazine, Dawah magazine, is by ISNA, The Message. 50,000. Do you know there is a small cult in Christianity called as Jehovah's Witnesses? Outcast than the mainstream Christian. They print a magazine by the name of Watchtower. Do you know how much do they print? Monthly, how much do they print? Can anyone guess? We maximum in USA 50,000. How much do they print? Any guesses? You won't lose any money. Any guesses? How much? Huh? 1 million! Direct 1 million. Any other guesses? 50,000? 5 lakh? 5 million! 5 million. 1,100,000. You know how much they print? 20.83 million. Leave aside, we Muslim, we can't print, we can't even think. Leave aside printing, we can't even think. The Christian, a small outcast group known as Jehovah's Witnesses, they print two magazines. Out of one is Watchtower, which they print semi-monthly, not monthly, twice a month. Each time they print is 20.83 million, more than 20 million in 130 languages. They print every fortnight, twice a month they print. Every time they print is 20.83 million, means every month they print more than 41 million in 130 languages. Their second magazine is Awake. They print 16 million twice a month, means more than 32 million. Four-color job, they give free. We Muslims, leave aside printing, we can't even think. See, you don't have to pay any money to guess. Maximum was 5 million. They print 41 million every month. We can't even think. And they distribute free. Sometimes they keep a nominal price. In India, 2 rupees, 16 halala. What is 16 halala? Name say, if you want, they'll give you as many copies as you want free. In 130 languages, Watchtower, Awake in 80 languages. This is how they propagate. And one of the media is giving lectures, giving talks. We had a talk, Islam Research Foundation, where I come from, in Bombay. I had a talk in Bombay
in Azad Maidan. And it was a good big talk compared to the population. Bombay has a big population, but getting people in Bombay is very difficult. If you get 200 people for an Islamic talk in English, it is great success. That means you have done a great job, because Bombay is a busy city. People don't have time to listen. We did a talk. The press said 200,000 people came, but we know it was 20,000 people. The press exaggerated. We know, we were the organizer. I gave a talk on similarities between Hinduism and Islam. 20,000 people came. It was done professionally. We had Jimmy Jibs, big one, not the small one, big Jimmy Jib. We had 9 cameras in a good way, professional way. Many Muslims said, they might have spent a lot of money. Now 10 lakh to kharcha kiye. 9 or 10 lakhs, at least 1 million rupees they might have spent. Israf. They might have spent at least 10 lakhs. It is 80,000 dirhams. At least $20,000 they have spent. Israf. They don't know what we actually spent. What we actually spent was about 28 to 30 lakhs. It is 3 times more than the estimate. We spent $60,000, about 250,000 dirhams. You know why I'm telling this? Immediately 2 weeks after that, Benny Hinn. Who has heard of Benny Hinn? He's an American Christian speaker. He's an American preacher. How many people have heard of Benny Hinn? Raise your hand. Benny Hinn. Hardly 30 people may have raised hand. In an audience of about 8,000 to 10,000 people here, more than 8,000 people, only 20, 30 hands I can see who have heard of Benny Hinn. Unknown. Very popular person. Even I did not know Benny Hinn till he came to Bombay. He comes to Bombay, and 6 weeks after our talk, he has 3 lectures on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for 3 hours each. 3 hours each, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You know how much he spends? People are saying, Dr. Zakir Naik, $20,000 he spent. Actually, we spent $60,000. If they come to know, they will blame me more. Israf. You know how much he spent? How much? Now he lost talent. He spent $5 million. Only for 9 hours, $5 million in the city of Bombay. What a budget they have. $5 million. The press said that more than 2 million people came, but actually less than 100,000 people came. Even getting 100,000 people in Bombay, out of which more than 50% were non-Christians. I went to attend that program. They had these Jimmy Jibs. They had Jimmy Jibs flown from America. 9 American people came 2 weeks to 1 month in advance to prepare for the talk. 1 month staying in a 5-star hotel. White American. He comes 3 days in advance to check the system. They had 32 screens. You know this screen? That bigger screen than this, 32. We had 500 volunteers, we are proud. 500 volunteers, they had 7,000 volunteers. Christians, not even 3% of the Indian population, they're not even 3%. $5 million, they spent more than 20 crore rupees. More than 200 million rupees they spent. Imagine, they flew over the crew. Only for one program, 3 hours, 3 days, and he goes back. If you know the budgets of this Christian missionary organization, on average, it is more than $1 million a day. Jimmy Swaggart, who debated with Sheikh Ahmed Didat, he required more than $400 million annually to keep his head above water. More than $1 million a day is their budget. We are nothing. I don't know for any Islamic Dawah organization in the world which even has 10% of that budget. Any Dawah organization, I have traveled different parts of the world. But the professionalism that they have, these Christian missionaries, they are trained. They are trained in giving talks. We hardly know of any Islamic Dawah organization who trains people in public speaking. Today, scientific research tells us that if a person gives a talk on the stage in public, the matter he speaks carries only 7% weightage. Only 7%. 93% is presentation skills. How does he modulate his voice, his eye-to-eye contact, his gestures? The reason I don't have a podium is why? not that I have a very good physique, is because I want to have my body language, even my body speaking. We in Islamic Research Foundation Bombay, we train professionally Muslims how to convey the message of Islam. We train not only Indians, we even train foreigners. We have got Americans who have come to our organization. We have got Britishers, people from Singapore, from UAE, from Malaysia, from Saudi Arabia, scholars who have passed from Madinah University. We train them, we specialize in the field of how to convey the message of Islam. How many Muslim organizations we have? Imagine, how can I die? How can I go in the battlefield without my weapon? If the microphone system is not good, how can I fight? This is my weapon. But when Muslim organizations call me throughout the world, they keep me in a five-star hotel, but the sound system is useless. When I accept an invitation, I tell them, the sound system should be good. I will sleep on the floor, no problem. I don't require a five-star hotel. I'm a Dai. I can sleep on the floor. But give me a good sound system, it doesn't cost much. But give a professional good sound system. To hire doesn't cost much, it is much less. A small percentage of paying the bill for a five-star hotel. They'll keep me in a five-star hotel, but they don't realize the importance of the sound system. What we Muslims should do, we should train ourselves in the media. To specialize in the field of public speaking is a specialty. Print media is a different specialty. Audio media is a different specialty. Video media is a different specialty. We have to be specialized. And today, we have radio broadcast stations. How many Muslims are doing their job? How many? We have the computer, we have the internet. When the internet started, there was more information against Islam than for Islam on the internet. Now, alhamdulillah, there are some Muslims who have also got into the field. But the Christians are ahead of us. The moment we give a reply, they give the counter reply on the internet. And the sites are such, I don't want to name them, I don't want to make them popular. The sites are such, you will think it is an Islamic site. You'll go to it, it is a snake in your sleeves. The magazine that they print, they have organizations in India, Darul Nijat, Home of Salvation. Arabic name. Who is the president? Sultan. Sultan who? Sultan Paul. Nidai Umid, call for hope. It's a Christian organization. So please don't go on names. Same on the internet you go. I don't want to give the names of this site, otherwise everyone will go and many will get misguided. They give such information which a normal Muslim, even he will not be able to reply. They pick up verses of the Quran and they attack.
I am Mukhtar Maharawi. You are watching Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Islam covers all aspects of this life and the hereafter.
We begin with the letter A. A is for what? A is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth.
The do's and don'ts, the freedom to choose, to decide our way of life.
My prayer, my fasting, my zakah, my hajj, my slaughter.
As per our wise creator's will or our uncertain human will.
Everything is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Bilal Ismail.
Purification, a super important matter in our sharia, as we will learn A to Z of purification.
Appreciate the holistic approach of Islam in dealing with various affairs of life in A to Z series. Every Monday at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 8:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم.
A light from Allah in the darkness.
له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه
a guide from Allah in the confusion.
يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ.
A cure from Allah for every sickness.
وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَئُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ.
The Quran. Join me, Muhammad Timhum, as we study the beautiful passages of the Quran and the great lessons that they contain in Lessons from the Quran.
Study about the glorious lessons that connect us to our Creator, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, in Lessons from the Quran. Next on Peace TV.
So as I told you, the media is good as well as bad. It is positive as well as negative, like a knife. It can be used for good purpose and for wrong purpose. If you cut vegetables and bread, it is good. If you use for robbing, it is bad. Similarly, the media has got advantages and disadvantages. It has got positive points, it has got negative points. It has good things, it has got bad things. What we should do, we should utilize the science and technology and turn the tables over and utilize it for good work. Today, majority of the media is used for work which is not good. That's the reason most of the ulama, most of the shuyukhs, they say that the media, stay away from it, and I'm for them. I'm not against them, I'm for them. Because most of the thing that comes in your house, the satellite channel, it makes you go away from Islam rather than towards Islam. And today's Taj Sister, number one media today is the television media, the television satellite media. Today's statistics tell us there are more than 20,000 television stations. 20,000 television stations reaching 5 billion people of the world. More than 80% of the human beings are reached via the television media. This is the survey. Means if you take part in the television media, the satellite media is reaching 80% of the world population. 5 billion people. And the investment in this media is how much? $400 billion. $400 billion is the investment in this media, and people are churning money out of it. The majority, more than 98%, more than 99% is haram. Haram. Obscenity, misinformation, taking away from the truth. More than 99%. We have to utilize it and turn the tables over. Imagine $400 billion invested only in the television media. Christians owning 50 channels, 100 channels, just making money out of it. In America alone, there are 1,673 television stations, out of which 83 are religious channels. Majority, almost all, they're Christian channels. Majority. Throughout the world, there are hundreds of Christian channels. Hundreds. There are Hindu channels. There are Jain channels. How many Muslim channels do we have? How many? In India, we have several Hindu channels. We have in India Christian channels in regional language. In English, we have several channels. We have in the regional South Indian languages only for a part of India, specialized targeting. There are hundreds of Christian channels. Number one is the God TV. Who has heard of the God TV? Oh, mashallah, more people know of God TV than many Hindus. God TV was launched about 10 years ago in 1995 by a Britisher. But it is uplinked from Israel. Do you know at present they are on 15 different satellites reaching more than 200 countries and having a viewership of 275 million people. 275 million people is the reach. 200 countries, 15 satellites they have hired. The God channel is one, but they have a separate God channel for Asia, separate for Europe, separate for America, separate for India. Specialization. Like how the BBC, there's BBC World is different, BBC Asia is different, BBC Europe is different. Why? The 90% the matter is same, but they want to even take advantage of the prime time. Prime time in UK is different than in UAE. It is different in Bombay. So according to the prime time, they cater the program and they shift the timings. So they hire different satellites. So God channel is one of the most popular among the Christian missionary channels. But Christian channels, there are hundreds of them. How many Islamic channels do we have? I know of many Muslims owning many entertainment channels. Many, 5, 10, 20, many. I don't want to name them, you may be knowing. They have groups of channels. How many Islamic channels do we have? How many channels do we have for Dawah? The first one that was launched was by Qadianis, MTVA, Muslim TV Ahmadiyya. They aren't Muslims. Muslim TV Ahmadiyya, and it even comes in UAE, in Dubai. Muslim TV Ahmadiyya. Normally when you see that channel, you think it's a Muslim channel. The name is also Muslim TV, but they aren't the true mainstream Muslims. They aren't. Alhamdulillah, about 8 years back, the first Islamic channel launched was Iqra TV, but mainly it was Arabic. Then we have Majad TV, then we have Fajr. But all these channels, they are basically Arabic channels catering to the Muslim Ummah. They're mainly targeting the Middle East. They are Islamic channels, but you will not call them as Dawah channels. They aren't channels which are propagating Islam to non-Muslims, but mainly catering to the Muslim Ummah. We have other channels which are localized only in Europe. We have other channels which are localized in other parts of the world. What we require is a full-time 24-hour Dawah channel to convey the message of Islam, to remove the misconception what the media is spreading against Islam. I was here a few years back, again, on the invitation of the Holy Quran Award Dubai. And that time it came in headlines in the local newspaper, I think it was Khaleej Times, that Dr. Zakir Naik calls for an Islamic TV. I'd give a lecture in Al-Boom. The topic was different, but in the question answer session, I said, we Muslims require a full-time satellite Dawah channel in English, which is the international language. We have newspapers which are in local language, only in Urdu. Who reads it? Only the Muslims in India or in Pakistan. We have Arabic newspaper read only by the Arab Muslims. See, this should be there. I'm not saying this is wrong. But what we require is a Dawah newspaper, a Dawah satellite channel. Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, I always believe in the philosophy that whatever the project is, don't wait if the project is big. See, we are a very small organization. If the project is big, whatever Allah has given you, start with it. If you have 1,000 riyals, 1,000 dirhams, start with it. Inshallah, you'll get success. So 8 years back, we started producing programs for satellite channel. And alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, we are supplying every day for half an hour to 2 hours to more than 6 international satellite channels. 6 every day. Not only to Muslim channels like Iqra TV, QTV, ARY Digital Islam channel, even to non-Muslim channels, Film Song channel, ETC, 24 Film Song Haram, at least half an hour there is halal. They see a joker looking person. They see a joker looking person. Who's the joker looking person wearing a coat and a cap and a kufi and a tie? And somebody asking a question that why does Islam permit a man to have more than 4 wives? Ah, abhi maza aayega, now we'll enjoy. And then the reply comes logically, and many are convinced. So what we have done, we have always said, this is a material free, don't pay us. Because when we go to that, we have spent so many thousands of dollars producing it, the moment we charge, maximum them show is once a week. We say, take it free. And mashallah, most of them show it daily, because they're getting it free. We will get a thawab in the akhirah, inshallah. As I mentioned that a few years back in Al-Boom, I'd mentioned that there should be Islamic TV, a Dawah channel. Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, you'll be happy to know that inshallah, in the next 2 to 3 weeks, we will be launching an Islamic Dawah channel by the name of Peace TV. We don't have the budget like the Christian missionary. We don't have. We are very small. Small people. Whatever we have, inshallah. We have called it the Peace TV. So the media is with war, with Islam, but we are with peace with humanity. Peace in Arabic, Salam, it also means Islam. And inshallah, it will be a Dawah-oriented channel, initially reaching Europe, Australia, Africa, Middle East, and Asia. We'll be on Panam Sat 10 initially. Later on, within a few months, we'll even go to USA, inshallah. And very shortly, within 1 year, inshallah, we'll try and cover this full globe, inshallah. It will basically be an English satellite channel, but we don't want to lose the time which is not a prime time. What is not prime time in Europe and the English countries, it will be prime time in India and Pakistan. That time we will show programs in Hindi and Urdu, so that we also want to cover the non-Muslims of India. So 25% initially will be in Hindi and Urdu, 75% will be in English, inshallah. And I request you to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inshallah, with this Peace TV, we'll be able to spread the religion of peace throughout the world, inshallah.
اقرأ خيّا ورتل القرآن اصبح بصوتك اسمع الأكوان اقرأ كلام الله داوي نفوسنا لنحس في أعماقنا أعماقنا الإيمان
Many people are misguided by films, the internet, and parties. But the future lies in the youth of today. Will there ever be